Hi students, friends, good morning to all. I welcome you all in this video lectures. So in today's lecture, we are going to start with a new unit from the second section. That is unit number 4, conveyance of water. So in this unit, we are going to learn the different types of conduits which can be used for the conveying of the water. Okay, like open channels, then tunnel, then aqueduct, and different types of pipes. Then we will learn in this unit how to find out the economic diameter of the pipe. Then what are the these are the contents as per university syllabus. We have the 8 hours weightage for this unit. Points here we are going to learn are transmission of water, pumping and gravity mains, choice of pipe materials, stresses in the pipe, economic size of the conveying main, distribution reservoirs, service storage, necessity, location, design. Here in design, head and capacity. These are the methods that are required, used for the design requirements, finding the design requirements of the pipe or the storages. Okay, so this is the content. Next is the questions, assignment number 4. And these are the different questions have been asked in examination, university examination from this unit. Okay, what are the questions? The first question is explain analytical method for finding capacity of elevated service reservoir. Then second question, explain design of thrust block in detail with all necessary equations. Next, explain mass balancing capacity of reservoir by using mass curve. Next question, write a short note on economic diameter of pumping main. Next question, how to calculate capacity of elevated service reservoir? Explain any one method in detail. Next question, explain the types of stresses in the distribution system. So these are the different questions that have been asked in university examination. Okay, mass balancing here, explain. So these are the different assignment questions. Now let us move in the theory part from this unit, conveyance of the water. So we know that water is drawn from the source of the water, and to draw the water from the source we require intake structures, right? And then after taking or drawing the water in the intake, from the intake, then we need to carry that water to the treatment plants, right? And this carrying of the water from the treatment plant by various means is nothing but it is a conveyance of water. Okay, and generally that treatment plant is located near to the city, and source of water it may be somewhat away from the sources, so we require the conveyance system for carrying the water from the source to the treatment plant. Okay, and again after treatment of the water we need to distribute that water in the city. Either it may be by gravity main or it may be by under pressure. So for all these things we require the conveyance system. Okay, see here, this is a diagram which represents the conveyance of water. First one is the source, then we have to carry that water from the source to the intake. then from it will be carried from intake to the water treatment plant, and then from water treatment plant it has been given to the distribution system, and through that distribution system it is conveyed to the consumer's tap. Okay, so what is conduit? Conduit is nothing but it is any structure for transportation of water from source to the water treatment plant and subsequent distribution to the city. So here conduit is nothing but any structure which transport the water from the source to the water treatment plant and from that plant treatment plant to the consumer's tap. Okay, so all that structures which come under this are called as the conduits. So here we can classify the conduits broadly as a gravity conduits and pressure conduit. Okay, we know that water always flows from higher head to the lower head. Okay, so it may flow by gravity or it may flow by the under pressure. If there is a elevation, source of the water is at the elevation, and we have to distribute the water at the lower elevation, then water can flow by the gravity. Okay, and if the source of water is at the lower level, then and if the treatment plant is at higher level, then we require the pressure system. Okay, we have to carry that water under pressure. It will not flow against the gravity. Okay, or again from the water treatment, if it is at the lower level and the distribution system is at the higher level, then also we will require to carry the water under pressure. Okay, so these are the two ways by which we can carry or convey the water from one point to the another point, that is gravity conduit and pressure conduit. Again, in the gravity conduit we have four types, like open channel, aqueduct, tunnels and flumes. Okay, and in the pipe pressure flow we have the pipes and tunnels. So the water can flow through the pipe under pressure, and through the tunnels also it can flow under pressure. So these are the different conduits that we will see it one by one now. Okay, out of this all conduits, the most popular conduit is the pipe. Okay, so what are the advantages of using pipe? You might be known well known about that. Can anyone tell me what are the advantages of using pipe as a conduit for carrying water from one point to the another point over the other types of conduits? Can anyone tell me? Using a pipe as a conduit than using other types of conduit, what are the advantages? Anyone can unmute and you can give the answer to the question, or put your answers in the chat box. Okay, to make the questions more simpler, I will ask you the difference or comparison between pipe flow and tunnel flow. Okay, if you are carrying the water through the tunnel, that open channel and the pipe flow, if the water is flowing through the open channel and water is flowing through the pipe, which is having more advantages? And why pipe flow or pipe conduit is used widely as compared to the other types of conduits?
Evaporation does not take place in pipe conduit.
Correct. So in case of pipe flow, evaporation is not taking place, as in open channel the evaporation takes place. Okay, you might have learned this thing in the irrigation engineering subject. There we have studied the disadvantages of canals or open channels. The one disadvantage of the open channel is that evaporation losses. Okay, second disadvantage of using open channel or any open system is that there may be seepage losses there, it may occur in the open channel. If that open channel is not lined, this is a lining केलेलं असेल, then definitely there will be seepage losses will occur there, right? Third thing is that the chances or probability of pollution of water, it increases. Okay, if we carry the water through the open channel, so the surrounding area, from the surrounding area, any kind of pollutant, it may get added as it is open to the atmosphere, it is open to the surrounding. So the different types of impurities may be added in the water and the water may get polluted, right? So these are the different disadvantages. Again, there is a very less flexibility in open channel. If you want to alter something, I changes karay astil, then it will become more difficult. In case of pipe flow, pipe system, it is quite easy to alter the pipe diameter. Okay, you can easily replace the pipe. Okay, but similarly, here in contrast to that pipe in open channel, it is more rigid system. Okay, so this is one more disadvantage of using open channel. Similarly, again in the tunnels, if you see, the cost of construction will be more in the aqueduct and then flumes. So that's why pipe flow, it is more popular nowadays. Again, in pipes we have the different materials, pipe materials that we are going to see, and out of that different pipe materials, the PVC pipe material is, it is most commonly used for the smaller or mid size treatment system or the water supply systems. Okay, now let us see here the one by one. This is a different system here, open channel. So it is easily and cheaply constructed by cutting the ground, right? In the diagram, in the figures, you can see the different types of channels. Okay, this is the line canal here. This is the lining, having the canal with lining, and this we can say it is an unlined canal. So very less seepage will occur here in this canal, but evaporation losses are invariably there in this particular channel. So these are the different cross sections of the channel. Okay, circular, then rectangular, trapezoidal, then triangular. Okay, so depending upon the type of soil, these are preferred. Generally, a rectangular section and trapezoidal sections are more popular because the construction is more easy for this. In which soil we prefer the rectangular section and which soil we prefer the trapezoidal section? Can anyone suggest, tell the answer? In which terrain, when to prefer the rectangular section and when to prefer the trapezoidal section of the channel? Yes, any idea? Okay, see, if the soil here or the terrain is very soil is very loose soil, okay, yeah, you can consider soil loose soil asil, or we can say high type of soil, loosely or we can say alluvial type of soil, loose soil, in that case we cannot go for the rectangular section. Jar apan tyari kani asa rectangular section kila, the sides of the channels are steep, they are having very steep slope, so there is a possibility of falling the side soil from the side of the wall. Okay, itun hi aap mari soil adi kani padu shakte. Okay, so for that purpose, the side soil, in this case the channel is given certain slope. Okay, soil is a phi angle asto, what we call it as a phi angle, angle of repose. Okay, so या अँगलला किंवा त्यापेक्षा कमी अँगलला त्या ठिकाणी the slope has been given to the soil so that it will not get fall from the sides. And when the terrain is rocky terrain, जर त्या ठिकाणी हार्ड स्ट्रेटा अवेलेबल असेल, रॉकी टेरेन असेल, इन दॅट केस द रेक्टँग्युलर सेक्शन इज प्रेफर्ड. ओके, बिकॉज इट विल रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट ऑफ कन्स्ट्रक्शन अँड वी कॅन गो डीपर ॲज मच वी वॉन्ट अँड देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ फॉलिंग ऑफ द सॉइल फ्रॉम द साईड बिकॉज इट इज रॉकी इन नेचर अँड लाईनिंग ऑल्सो इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड इन दिस केस. सो दिस इज द थिंग यू शुड नो दॅट in which soil we should prefer the rectangular section and which soil we should go for the trapezoidal section. In case of the open channel, the velocity of the water should not exceed 0.9 meter per second, and to avoid the leakage or seepage problem we should go for the lining of the channel. Aqueduct. Now in this term aqueduct, it is actually the aqueduct, whatever you have learned, you might have learned there in the irrigation engineering or the water resource engineering, is the structure which we construct across the valley or any kind of natural drain. That structure to carry the water is called as the aqueduct. But nowadays aqueduct word, it is loosely used for the terms like for the conduits carrying the water, okay, or we can say a closed conduit carrying the constructed with the machinery, or and it is used for conveying the water from the source to the treatment plant or point of distribution. Okay, so this aqueduct, it may be constructed with bricks, stones or the reinforced concrete. In olden days rectangular aqueducts were used, but nowadays horseshoe म्हणजे काय, वड्याच्या पायामध्ये जे नाळ असते त्या शेपमध्ये पण हे, किंवा सर्क्युलर शेपमध्ये पण त्या ठिकाणी दिस ॲक्युडक्ट्स आर कन्स्ट्रक्टेड. ओके, मोस्टली दिस ॲक्युडक्ट्स आर कन्स्ट्रक्टेड इन सिमेंट कॉन्क्रीट अँड द ॲव्हरेज वेलॉसिटी ऑफ फ्लो हिअर इट शुड बी 1 मीटर पर सेकंड. सो यू कॅन सी हिअर दिस डायग्राम फॉर द ॲक्युडक्ट, right? Then tunnels. Okay, if there is a high rise ground or terrain there in between the source of water and the treatment plant, or between the treatment plant and the city, then tunnel can be excavated to carry the water between these two points. Okay, gravity conduit, but sometimes water flows under pressure, so this water flows by the gravity through these tunnels. But sometime if it is completely filled with the water, then it can flow under the gravity, under pressure. Okay, and again here the cross section of these tunnels, it may be circular or it may be horseshoe type. Okay, and generally pressure tunnels are constructed in circular cross section. Then comes the flumes. Open channel supported over the ground by trestle, these are the called as the flumes. Okay, used for conveyance of water across the valley or minor low lying areas or over the drains or any other obstructions coming in the way. Constructed with RCC, wooden material or metals. Common sections here are rectangular or circular sections are used for the construction of the flume. Then comes the pipes. So this is the most widely used and popular way of conveying water from one point to the another point. The circular conduits in which water flows under pressure or under gravity. So through the pipe water may flow under pressure or it may be flow under gravity. If we consider the sewage system there we use the pipe system. Okay, and water there water flows under gravity, but generally in most of the cases we use the pipe system for the pressurized flow. Okay, प्रेशर ज्या ठिकाणी असेल त्यासाठी आपण शक्यतो आपण काय करतो पाईप्स हा प्रेफर करतो. नाउडेज दिस पाईप प्रेशर पाईप्स हॅव इलिमिनेटेड द यूज ऑफ चॅनल्स ॲक्विडक्ट्स अँड टनल्स. सो नाउडेज पीपल्स आर प्रेफरिंग पाईप ओवर दिस चॅनल्स ॲक्विडक्ट कंड्यूट्स ओके देन टनल्स याच्यापेक्षा हे पाईप फ्लोला त्या ठिकाणी प्रेफरन्स दिला जातो. सो व्हॉट आर द व्हेरियस मटेरियल्स विच आर यूज्ड as a pipe material. Okay, you can see here these are the various types of the materials which has been used for the construction manufacturing of the pipes. So cast iron is there, then wrought iron, MS steel, mild steel is there, concrete, cement concrete is there, asbestos is there, then timber is there, plastic is there, copper, lead, vitrified clay. So these are the different materials which are used for manufacturing of the pipe. So we'll see this various types of pipes here. So this in the first diagram you can see this is the cast pipe or cast iron pipe, then this is the steel pipe, then these are the concrete pipes, the fourth one is the asbestos cement pipe, AC pipes. Okay, then this is the vitrified clay pipes, these are the copper pipes, then wrought iron pipes, then PVC pipes. Okay, so these are the different materials or the different types of pipes are used for conveying the water from one point to the another point. Okay, pipe material selection criteria. So on which basis we should select out of these different pipes, how to decide which material or which type of pipe we should select. Okay, that criteria we will see now. Pipe material selection criteria. So these pipes can be selected on the basis of following points. First one is the carrying capacity of the pipe. Okay, we have to see what is the carrying capacity of the pipe. Okay, carrying capacity means how much discharge it can carry and with how much pressure. Second point is durability and lifespan of the pipe. Okay, if you want to use the pipe system for the long duration, then we should select the pipe. We should not select the pipe like copper pipe or then iron pipe, because they will get corroded. Instead of that, we can go for this concrete pipe or steel pipe, or we can prefer the wrought iron pipes like that. Okay, so they will survive, they will last long depending upon the durability and lifespan. Type of water to be conveyed and its corrosive effect on the pipe material. If the water is somewhat corrosive in nature, then we should avoid using metallic pipe like this copper, then wrought iron, steel pipe, cast iron. Okay, we should avoid, and instead of that we should prefer the concrete pipe or then vitrified clay pipe, then PVC pipe. This can be preferred over that. Next point is about the availability of fund. So if the pipe, costly pipe, if the funds availability is less, then we should prefer for the less costly pipe system, and if the funds availability is more, then we can go for the costlier pipes. Then maintenance cost and repair. The pipe should be selected such that it will have a less maintenance and less repair work. Okay, for example, if we go for this wrought iron or any cast iron or steel pipes, the maintenance issue, if it gets corroded, then we have to replace this systems. Okay, at the joint also many times it happens the pipe get corroded and we have to replace that pipe systems. Okay, so as compared to the other pipes like this concrete pipe or the asbestos pipe or the PVC pipe, these pipes having low maintenance. Copper also get corroded easily, so these pipes will have less maintenance. The leakage problem will be there in case of the pipe PVC pipes. Okay, at the joints pipe may get leakage, so it will be also having somewhat maintenance. Then the pipe material which will use the smallest annual cost or the capital cost will be selected. Okay, such pipes will be selected which gives the less annual cost. This annual cost or recurring cost we can say, and this is the capital cost once we lifespan of this pipe purchase cost we can say, because it will be mostly economical. So in this way, this affects the, these criteria affect the pipe material selection. Okay, as per our requirement, we should go for the material selection of the pipe. Next is economic diameter of pumping main. Okay, the main pump I have pumping main ahe. Pumping main means main pipeline which we carry the water from the source to the water treatment plant. Okay, so that is the pumping main. Here water flows under pressure. Okay, the source is at lower level and the treatment plant is at higher level. We require a pump for carrying water from lower point to the higher point. Okay, and that pipeline which is laid there, that pipeline is called as the pumping main. Now here in the pumping main, we are going to find out what should be the economical diameter of the pumping main. You might be aware that cost of the pipe, it increases as the diameter of the pipe increases. Okay, large diameter is the pipe asel, then it will having very less price or less cost. Jashi pipe chi diameter vadat jate, tyachi cost pan vadat jate. Okay, do you know this thing? Have you gone to the shop to purchase the pipe? आपल्या घरी पण जे आपण पाईप वापरतो किंवा शेतीमध्ये जो पाईप वापरतो, लहान डायमीटर असेल तर त्याची प्राइस कमी असते आणि जशी डायमीटर वाढत जाते तशी पाईपची कॉस्ट पण त्या ठिकाणी वाढत जाते. सो द थिंग मे कम इन युअर माइंड दॅट इन्स्टेड ऑफ युझिंग लार्जर डायमीटर पाईप, वाय शुडंट वी गो फॉर स्मॉलर डायमीटर पाईप, बिकॉज कॉस्ट इज रिड्युसिंग देअर, राईट? पाईपची आपल्याला त्या ठिकाणी जी कॉस्ट आहे ते आपली वाचते त्या ठिकाणी. सो वी शुड, यू मे थिंक दॅट वी शुड गो फॉर द स्मॉलर डायमीटर पाईप. ओके, बट व्हॉट विल हॅपन इफ वी गो फॉर द स्मॉलर डायमीटर ऑफ द पाईप? ओके, सो दॅट थिंग इज एक्सप्लेन ऑन द स्लाईड नंबर, ऑन द प्रिव्हियस स्लाईड. ओके, सी हियर द टोटल डायनामिक हेड. Now water flows because of the total dynamic head. Total dynamic head त्या ठिकाणी असतो, त्यामुळे water जे आहे ते higher head to lower head त्या ठिकाणी flow होतं. And whatever the pump we are using there, centrifugal pump, reciprocating pump, any kind of pump, that pump has to overcome this head. म्हणजे हा total head जो आहे त्या head पेक्षा जास्त त्या ठिकाणी power त्या ठिकाणी काय करावं लागते, त्या पंपला generate करावे लागते. That pump has to generate that power or the head greater than this total dynamic head. So what is that total dynamic head? This total dynamic head consists of a static head, then velocity head, and head loss due to friction. Okay, or head loss through the pipe. What is the static head? Static head is nothing but it is the elevation difference between the two point. Suppose pump is here and treatment plant is here, so whatever this elevation difference is there, here this we can call it as a static head. Then what is velocity head? The velocity head is nothing but the head given by the virtue of the head of the water or the energy of the water by virtue of its velocity, and it is represented by letter this equation v square upon 2g. So we have learned this velocity head. Okay, म्हणजे या ठिकाणी पाण्याला जेवढी वेलॉसिटी असेल तेवढा वेलॉसिटी हेड त्या पाण्यामध्ये त्या ठिकाणी असतो. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो कम अंडर दिस. अँड लास्ट वन इज द हेड लॉस, मायनर लॉसेस अँड मेजर लॉसेस इन द पाईपलाईन. ओके, So all these losses has to be overcome, or collectively we call it as a total dynamic head. Okay. So out of these three heads here, these two heads depends upon the velocity. Okay, हे दोन हेड जे आहेत ते कशावरती डिपेंड करतात? व्हेलॉसिटीवरती डिपेंड करतात. सो व्हेलॉसिटी हेड, जस्ट नाउ वी हैव सीन दैट इक्वेशन वी स्क्वेअर अपॉन टू जी इन द कंपट, इट इज व्हेलॉसिटी हेड. एंड व्हाट अबाउट दिस हेड लॉस ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन? सो इट इज ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स अपॉन द व्हेलॉसिटी, 4FLV² अपॉन 2GD. सो दिस इक्वेशन वी हैव लर्न, दैट इज डार्सीज वेक इक्वेशन. इन दिस इक्वेशन इफ यू सी द हेड लॉस HF, इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन directly proportional to the square of the velocity. Okay, so as velocity increases, this loss also increases, head loss due to friction as well as this velocity head, both heads will increase. And as these two heads increases there, the total dynamic head will increase. Okay, and total dynamic head increase zalan mhanje kay, tya tikani pump has to provide more power, pump has to utilize more electricity to overcome this head. Okay, je ya tikani more power consumption hoil, ani more power consumption zala mhanje kay, ya tikani more electric bill je ahe te ya tikani vadel, mhanje kay, the cost of electric cost of the recurring maintenance or recurring cost je ahe dar mahinyane dar bill je te ya tikani vadel. Okay, हे मी का सांगत होतो, या ठिकाणी हे व्हेलॉसिटी वाढलं तर हे आपण या ठिकाणी ह्या सगळ्या गोष्टी होतील. व्हेलॉसिटी का वाढेल? सी हियर, वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द पाईप डायमीटर, राईट. पाईपची जर आपण डायमीटर जास्त घेतली तर हे कॉस्टली आहे, त्यामुळे आपण काय केलं, वी प्रेफर्ड द स्मॉलर डायमीटर.